Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Let us discuss about development of surfaces. Here we are taking one prism. Let us take the given data. After that we will develop the surface of the prism. Okay. Here the given data is a pentagonal prism of base side 30 mm and axis 70 mm is resting on its base on the HP. HP means horizontal plane, with a rectangular face parallel to the VP. VP means vertical plane, full stop. It is cut by an axillary inclined plane in the shortcut form axillary inclined plane. Okay. Whose vertical trace VT we are writing here is inclined at 45 degrees to the reference line and passes through the midpoint to the axis, full stop. Draw the development of the lateral surface of the prism. We need to do the development of the surface of this prism. Here first write the given data for the pentagonal prism. Okay. For example, I am taking this is a pentagonal prism. Okay, this side and this side has two pentagons. Okay, we can call it as base. And these two pentagons are connected with the help of rectangular surface. Okay, we can call it as rectangular face. Okay, so here how many rectangular faces? Each side of the pentagon is one side of the rectangle. Okay, five sides, five rectangular faces. Okay, now we need to develop this surface of this pentagon. Initially write down the given data. Here base side is 30 mm, axis is 70 mm, and it is resting on its base on the HP. Same thing I have written here with a rectangular face parallel to the VP. So same thing I have written here. So here if you see this data, base side means, as I told, this is a base. One side is 3 cm, means let us assume all the sides has equal length. Okay, 3 cm, because it is a regular pentagon. And after that axis is 70 mm, means height of this prism, this height is 7 cm. Okay, now after that base is on the HP. This is a base. I am assuming this is a horizontal plane. It is on the HP like this. Okay, after that, with a rectangular face parallel to VP. So this is a rectangular face. I am taking this is a vertical plane. Okay. So what it is parallel, this rectangular face is parallel to VP, means tilt the pentagon like this. Now this is the rectangular face. This is parallel to the vertical plane now. Okay, we have to do the projections for this position. Projections means top view of this prism and front view of this prism. In the top view, we can see the entire pentagon like this. Okay, this gap has not given from the vertical plane. So we can take any gap, and in the front view we can see the entire height, whatever height is here, the entire thing we can see here. First roughly initially I will do projections of it. Okay, now just now I told we can see the polygon like this in the horizontal plane. Just do the XY line. This is a vertical plane, this is a horizontal plane. In the top view you can see this polygon like this. Okay, mark A, B, C, D, E like that. This is the top view. For the bottom face, I am marking A, B, C, D like that. Mark 1, 2, 3 also. For the top surface, I will mark 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. 1 and A, okay, both are coming at the same point. So that's why two points are coming at the same point. A, 1, B, 2, C, 3 like that. Okay, D, 4, E, 5. Okay. After that, do the projectile lines like this. So above XY line in the front view we can see the entire head, this height. Okay, so do it. Height, as we know, it is 7 cm. Now here this line we can see from the front. Okay, and from the front we can't see these two corners, okay, which are passing through E and D. Okay, those should be dotted like this, correct? In the front view, this is a front view, this is a top view. For here we are marking, this is 1, just now I told, so it is 1 dash, this is A dash. Okay, and this B is, for the top surface we are marking points 2 dash, this is 2 dash, this is B dash, and here 3 dash, C dash. Here this is E5. Okay, 5 dash, E dash, and then this point is D, 4. Here for the top surface 4 dash, D dash like that. This diagram, front view and top view, that is the projection of this prism. Okay. So first do the XY line of any length. Here, after that do this polygon. This side is 3 cm. Okay. Use outer angle formula. This angle is 360 by n, where n is number of sides of the polygon, 5. Okay, it is 72 degrees. This outer angle is 72 degrees and this side also 72 degrees. Now here take 3 cm. Here take one line. The outer angle is 72 degrees. Here also the angle is, outer angle is 72. Okay, so take 3 cm on those lines. You will get the polygon. Use some gap here. Take 3 cm here, 72 degrees. Here we got one point. Take in this direction 3 cm. Now this side also take 72 degrees line. Here we got one point. Here take 72 degrees. So in this direction 3 cm line. Now check whether this is 3 cm or not. This is the closing side. Now this is exactly 3 cm. Mark the corners A, 1 here. Here B, 2. Here C, 3. Here D, 4. Here E, 5. Do the projectile lines up to the XY line. This projectile line should be 90 degrees to the XY. Okay. This protractor, this angle is 90. Okay. For getting 90 degrees line, keep at C point. So keep this scale should coincide with this XY line. Just do the line. So this is a projectile line. Similarly, at D point. So extend this line up to XY. Here mark the intersection points, so A dash, C dash, like that. So this is A dash, this is B dash, this is C dash, from D B dash, from E E dash. This is a top view we did here. For front view, we can see the entire head 7 cm. By using scale, mark that height. In the front view, we can see the entire box of 7 cm. From here, continuous line. And from these points, dotted lines. Now mark the intersection points. From A, here 1 dash. From B, this 2 dash. C, 3 dash. D, 4 dash. E, 5 dash. Doing the front view and top view, these are projections. After doing the projections, the next given data is, it is cut by an axillary inclined plane. Okay, one plane is cutting this prism. Okay, so that plane, in the shortcut form, we are writing AIP, axillary inclined plane, whose vertical trace is inclined at 45 degrees to the reference line. That cutting plane is 45 degrees to the plane, okay, to this XY line, 45 degrees. We can take in this direction or in this direction also, cutting plane. And then, and passes through the midpoint of the axis. This cutting plane is passing through the midpoint of the axis. So here this is the axis. Okay, so it is passing through midpoint of the axis. First mark the midpoint. So at that midpoint, take 45 degrees inclined plane in this direction or in this direction. It is our wish. Okay, this is also 45, this side, and this side also 45. Initially take the midpoint here on the axis line. Axis line means which is passing through center. Okay, as we know, center is on the middle line. So for the middle line, mark the middle point. As we know, this is 7 cm. Middle point means 3.5 cm from the XY. One point here. So the cutting plane is passing through this point and it is tilting 45 degrees. Now here, mark the 45 degrees line. Join this point to this point. We are getting the 45 degrees plane. Okay. Two big lines. Okay, like this. With dot. Okay. And then here small line, small dot, two big lines. Okay. Now this is, we are calling axillary plane. Okay, this plane we are showing two big lines with a dot. Okay. Give the intersection points. 1 to A I am giving, some anyway name we can give, P dash I am giving. 2 to B I am giving, U dash. For third line I am giving, R dash. And fourth line I am giving, S dash. Okay. This fifth line I am giving, T dash. Small letters. So you need this part I did make it light, this part I did dark color. Okay. Now for these are the final projections. Now here we have to do the development of the surface. Development of the surface means whatever surface is there, we are taking the entire surface in terms of one plane sheet. Okay, that is called development of surface. For example, I am covering the entire surface with a paper. Okay, just for getting example, all surfaces has covered here. Now after that, remove this entire surface. So this is the development of this prism. Okay, we are making all these surfaces in terms of one plane sheet. So this is the development of this prism. So how many rectangular faces? 1 here, 2 here, 3 here, 4 here, and then 5 here. 5 rectangular faces. How much this width means? So each side of the polygon, that is 3 cm, here 3 like that. Okay, 3 × 5, 15 cm this is. And this height is, whatever height is there, 7 cm. The entire surface we are getting in terms of sheet. First do this diagram. Okay, take some gap after this diagram. Just do one line, don't take common line here. This is XY line separate for this projection. Do separate. So the line length is the length of this rectangle. Okay, so as I told, this is 3 cm. Okay, the entire length is 3 × 5. Okay, 5 sides, each is 3 cm, 15 cm. So here after this diagram, do give some gap. Here do 15 cm line by using scale. Mark the end points. Now here after that, take this height, how much height it is, whatever height of the prism, 7 cm. Here take, this is the reference line. We can see the entire rectangle after development. So make complete this rectangle. Take, this is the reference line. Move the scale in upper direction. Mark the end points. Now join these two corners. Now after that, here we are seeing this rectangular shapes. Okay, rectangular faces, each is 3 cm width. Now here by using the scale, mark 3 cm on it. Here 3 cm, again 3 cm, 6, again 3 cm, 9 12. So this is the last one. Here at all these points, do the vertical lines. Okay, this is the development of this prism. After that, we have to mark the corners. Initially we are starting with A. I am marking here capital letters A and 1. And next, after A, we are taking B and 2. Here after B, C and 3. Here after C, D and 4. After D, E and 5. Here initial and final line should be same. Okay, this is A, here 1. We are doing the development of this prism. Mark these intersection points also on this development. Here on 1A, mark P. Okay, on 1A, we are taking the P point. Just do the projector lines. Take, this is a reference. So just do one line here up to this. Okay, 1A. And then next, at 2B, mark Q point. Here. Okay. And then 3 and C, mark this R point here. Just do one line here up to this. And then next, the fourth line, mark this S point on the fourth line. And then on the fifth line, mark this point. Okay, here. And then last line is nothing but the first initial line, mark P here. So this point is P point. Mark capital letters, because here we are marking capital letters. And then on 2 and B, Q point, this is Q. And next on 3 and C, this is R. And 4 and D, this is S point. And 5 and E, this point is T point. And again initial and last point is P point, mark P. Join all these points with the help of scale. After PQ, here QR is also coming on the same line. QR and then RS, HT, and then PT. After getting this line, make this part also same color, okay? Because we are removing this part. Okay, the whatever remaining part is there, it should be with the same color here. So this is the development of this part. Okay. Always remember, whatever part we are removing, it should be in light color with pencil only. Okay, this portion should be in light color, above portion, and below portion should be with dark color. Always remember, in the development of surfaces, first do the projections, front view and top view. After that, do some gap, do the development of the given surface. Mark the given dimension. Base side is 30 mm and axis side is 70 mm. And then mark this angle is 45 degrees. Keep arrows at both sides, and entire diagram should be with the pencil. Don't use pens and sketch pens. For getting the clear view, I am using the different colors.